whatever God says, that's it. Praise the Lord. If Sister Frederica is sitting in a pool of discouragement, and sometimes very lonely indeed, hallelujah, will we rally around and help?
No.
Hallelujah. Or will we just dig down the wall? Praise the Lord. If Brother Frederick hasn't been coming to church for a while, what do we say? Do we check them out? Are they sick? Are they weak? Are they discouraged? Is something gone wrong? Or do we just say, oh, well, I knew he was going to be around anyway. Just a matter of time anyway. Appreciate it. Appreciate it. Praise the Lord. Do we appreciate sometimes the good that is done by this church? Hallelujah. I'm going to repeat that one. Do we appreciate the good that is done by this church? Praise the Lord. I'm talking within the whole realms of the community, the Birmingham, the West, whatever we want to call it. Do we appreciate the good that this church does? Well, I'm not going to demand an answer, but you know. Praise the Lord. If we criticize this church, we criticize ourselves. Because we are the church. If we put a hindrance before this church, we're hindering ourselves. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If we want progress, then we have got to be prepared to step out and make progress. And let God be with us. Appreciate it. And if I'm going to make a confession while I'm preaching, I'll say I didn't realize just how good this church was until I started to go out and round about and see other churches. I'm not saying we should compare God or church, but I realized the value of this place. Praise the Lord. I don't care who's leading the service, that's not mine. I don't care who's giving the message, again, that's not mine. Who's singing on the choir, who's whatever, that's not it. It's not that. It's not everybody who's running to pulpit, that's not it. Praise the Lord, but this place, this particular place, praise the Lord, is an anointed place. Free. Praise the Lord. We often take each other for granted. Hallelujah. And sometimes we even have no respect. Praise the Lord. If we realize some of the brethren that were among us, or all the brethren that were among us, if we realize the position that we held, and the position our other brother and sister held. Praise the Lord. I'm talking heavenly now. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Then we would learn more quickly to appreciate. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I know, and I can speak from my heart freely. No contradiction or worry or fear of somebody jumping up and saying, no, it's not true. But I can speak from my heart and say that I appreciate everybody. Praise the Lord. No worries. I don't care if it's a young child or somebody old enough, my parent. I don't mind. I appreciate everybody. Praise the Lord. It's not something you have to learn. Hallelujah. If we have the Holy Ghost, praise the Lord. Because if your spirit bear witness with my spirit, hallelujah, praise God. You know, we all have one Father. Because we all have one name. You might say my name's Parkes and your name's Burke, but I believe that we have one name. It's Jesus' name. Hallelujah. One name. One God, one Father, one Spirit. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And I can appreciate my brother here, knowing that he has a connection with the same Father. Then I don't appreciate God. Praise the Lord. Appreciate Him. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You know, sometimes we're too quick to criticize. And yet the Bible says, keep thy foot when thou goest into the house of God. And I, you know, we were all ready to hear than to speak, and yet we're so quick. Why don't we be more quicker to praise or lift up or say, well done, hallelujah. If somebody's singing a song and it's going all wrong, help them to sing. Praise God. Praise God. Somebody could be leading a service and they're not quite sure. Help them. Hallelujah. Don't pull the other direction. Help. Hallelujah. Praise God. I am not worthy of anything. I am the least worthy of anything. God could have wiped me up and it would have been right. Hallelujah. God could have blotted my name out and it would still be a right decision. But because of mercy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We were all under the ban of condemnation. I don't care what your name is, where you live right now, but every one of us were under the banner of condemnation. Because David said, I was born in sin, shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. So when I was born, I was qualified for one thing, and that was just to die, just to be punished. Hallelujah. I never had no GCE, but I still qualified for hell. Hallelujah. I couldn't qualify to be a doctor, but I had one qualification, and that was to be condemned. Praise the Lord. But Jesus, hallelujah. But Jesus, one day Jesus, hallelujah. Appreciate it. Hallelujah. Hey, that brother's got a better car than me. That sister's got a better house than me. Oh, they got nicer clothes than me. Better job than me. Praise the Lord. God don't care what he has. Praise the Lord. Paul said, I have learned therefore to be contented. Hallelujah. With whatever God has given me. Hallelujah. And if I really need it, then if my brother or my something. Something Elder Martin said on Thursday that it really made me think. He said, it doesn't matter how we get treated in church. If we have our misunderstanding up and down, whatever, stay in church. Hallelujah. Stay here. Hallelujah. Stay with God. Not only stay with God, but encourage somebody else to stay. Hallelujah. 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 If you can help me to live, and I can help somebody else to live, we've achieved half the mission already. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This chain of love that God has wrapped us with goes all around the world. Hallelujah. It can never be broken. That's why Jesus looked at Peter and said, upon this rock, hallelujah, upon this rock. He wasn't pointing to Peter, he was pointing to himself and saying, upon this rock, I build my church. Hallelujah. And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Hell will try and defeat us, but it will never get the victory. Hallelujah. Appreciate it. I appreciate the fact that God has brought us this far. And if you can look back over the amount of years or months or weeks that you have been at this place, then surely you can only say it's Jesus. Hallelujah. We have come this far by faith.
Praise God.
congregation of 10, or 10% of the congregation. Hallelujah. 90% of the congregation got what they wanted, all right?
Yes.
But they kept on going their own way.
Yes.
Hallelujah. But 10% turned back and said, Lord, I just had to come back and say thanks. Hallelujah. Because I appreciate it. Hallelujah. 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 We may be surrounded by a multitude of friends, but count the friends who will appreciate you. It won't be a multitude. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. When the prodigal boy left home and he had all the money he could carry, and because of that he had all the friends he could carry. As a matter of fact, he had more friends than he could carry. Hallelujah. But when the money done, the friend done. Praise the Lord. And then he found himself, as a matter of fact, he had new friends. These friends were pigs. That's the new friend. Hallelujah. And as a matter of fact, he was even eating what the pig eat. He was hungry, so as a matter of fact, I don't know if he actually ate it, but I could imagine him pushing the pig out of the way and saying, let me have a bit. Praise the Lord. Wallowing. No friend. Praise the Lord. But then the time came when he came, the Bible says he came to himself. Hallelujah. He was in the pig pen, in the cesspool of life, an outcast from the society that he was once living in. But he came to himself and he began to remember home. Hallelujah. He didn't just remember home, but he remembered how he did not appreciate what he had at home. He remembered how he did not care for what he had. He remembered how he did not value what he had. Hallelujah. He said,